Hi there. In this video, we'll learn to create a trifold brochure in InDesign, so let's get started. Before we create a document, let me explain the setup so that you understand it well. So this is the layout of the outside panel. On the extreme left is the first page, which is the flap of the brochure. And that's why it's going to be slightly narrower than the rest of the pages, because it will fold inside and the front cover will rest on top of it. Page 2 will be the back of the brochure, and page 3 is going to be the front cover. Hence, we'll have information like the name of the company, address, etc. You can also find that the folds are coded with letters BAA, which is nothing but the masters that will be applied to them. Now, let's move on to the inside panel. Here, the page on the extreme left is page 4, which will have a master applied to it. And so will page 5, which is the center page. And the one on the extreme right is page 6, which is the back of page 1. Hence, it is also narrower than the other two pages and has B master applied to it. Now, keeping these settings in mind, let's create our document. I'm going to change the units to millimeters. I have already selected letter as the document size. Let's select the landscape orientation. And then click the width tab and enter the forward slash, which is considered the division sign, and then the number 3, as we need to divide the page into 3 individual pages, which will eventually be 6 pages back to back. The moment you move the cursor somewhere else, you shall find how brilliantly InDesign does the calculation for you of the width. Now remember, I told you that one panel is going to be narrower than the rest, which means the rest two panels will be broader than that one panel. So let's add another millimeter to this to make it broader. So instead of 93.133, it shall become 94.133 millimeters. Let's also uncheck the facing pages option and enter 6 pages. Update the margins to 10 millimeters and bleed to 3 millimeters. And hit create. Once in the document, drag the pages panel out and expand it. Now you can see all 6 pages have a master applied to them, and the width of the a master is 94.133 millimeters. So we'll need another master with a reduced width, as one panel of the trifold will be narrower. And when I say one panel, I mean 2 pages back to back. Let's take the cursor to the master zone and right-click and select New Master from the options. In the pop-up window, you can base your B master on a master, or even if you don't do that, it shouldn't really matter for now. But let's still select the based on master option to a master. Now, since our B master is going to be narrower and we have added a millimeter to the other two pages, we'll have to reduce those 2 millimeters from this narrower panel. So 93.133 was the original size, and minus 2 millimeters from it will bring it down to 91.133 millimeters. So let's enter that here and hit OK. Let me take you to our setup, and you can see that our page 6 was narrower and obviously had B master applied to it. Similarly, page 1, which is the back of page 6, is also narrower, hence has B master applied to it as well. So now we're going to replicate this setting to create the spread. So let's get back to InDesign and select page 1 and hold Command on a Mac or Control on a PC and click page 6 to select them both. Now take your cursor to page 1 and right click, and from the options select Apply Master to Pages option, and in the pop-up window update the Apply Master to B Master. You can find that the two pages are already selected here, so just hit OK. When you get this conflict pop-up, just hit Use Master Page Size. You can find that the selected pages have B master applied to them now. And our setup is now falling into place. So you can see the BAA and then AAB format. So let's place the pages together to create the spread. If you click page 2 and drag it to place it next to page 1, you'll find that it refuses to sit next to it. So what we need to do is click the burger menu at the top right corner of the pages panel and uncheck the allow document pages to shuffle option. Now when we try to drag page 2 to make it sit next to page 1, it will comfortably sit there. Drag page 3 next to page 2 the same way, So that's the spread for the outside panel ready. Similarly, drag page 5 and then page 6 next to page 4. And there you go. We've got our BAA set up for the outside panel and AAB for the inside panel. Let's work on the inside panel first. So let's double click page 4. First of all, we need to establish the center point of the spread. So grab the rectangle tool and make a rectangle as illustrated. Now drag a guide from the ruler above and place it at the center of the page. And do it for all three pages one by one. Once the center has been established, delete the rectangle. Now, using the rectangle tool, make a rectangle on page 4 covering the upper half of the page, including the bleed. Double-click the fill option and pick a color of your choice. I'm going to pick this shade of yellow. Holding Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, click and drag the rectangle to make a copy of it and place it at the bottom of page 5. You might find this rectangle slightly wider when we try to fit it here. It's because when we placed it on the top left corner, we included the bleed space as well, something we don't need while placing it here. Similarly, let's make another copy of the rectangle and place it at the top right corner. You might be surprised why the rectangle turns out to be wider again, as this portion also have bleed space, much like the one on top left. It's only because this panel is slightly narrower, remember? So adjust the width to fit it within the margins. Let's pick the rectangle tool and make another rectangle on top of this, but this time exclude the bleed space. Now drag a guide from the ruler above and drop it at the center of this rectangle you've just made. Now extend this rectangle to the margin on the left and then the margin on the right, excluding the bleed. Drag another guide from the ruler on the left and place it at the center point. The reason we had to do this extra step is because had we included the bleed space into our calculation, the center point would not be accurate. So let's now delete this rectangle since we've established the center point of this rectangle. Now grab the ellipse frame tool and holding Shift and Option on a Mac or Shift and Alt on a PC, click at the center point that we've just established and drag to make a circle. Similarly, using another rectangle, establish the center point of the yellow rectangle on the right, and then add a circle using the ellipse frame tool, much like we did with the first one. Finally, repeat the same steps to create another circle at the bottom of the center page. Next, holding Shift, click the three circular frames that you've created and go to File, and then Place, and locate three images that you'd like to put into these three frames, and hit Open. Once your cursor is loaded, click each frame once to insert the images. Next, grab the type tool and create a text box at the top of the center page. Type in our products or any other information you'd like to put in there. Actually, let's create a text box on the pasteboard and fill it with placeholder text so that we could conveniently borrow text from here. Now, select some text and copy it and then paste it in the text box in the center. Let's center align the text and do a little bit of paragraphing so that it looks presentable. Let's select the heading and change the font style to bold. Let's also update the font size to 18 points. Now let's select the first line of the text as is the subheading and change its font to Asylum. Similarly, select the body text and change it to a stylish font. So let's pick Typo Upright. Also, update the font size of the body text to 14 points. Now that we have styled our heading, subheading, and body text, it's time to add them to paragraph styles. So let's go to Window and then Styles and select Paragraph Styles. Once the Paragraph Styles panel is up, select the heading and create a new paragraph style and rename it Heading. Similarly, select the subheading and create another paragraph style and rename it Subheading. Lastly, select the body text and create a new paragraph style and rename it Body Text. Now that our styles have been created, select the subheadings one by one, as well as the body text under them, and assign the appropriate paragraph styles to them. Next, holding Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, click and drag the text box to the bottom left corner. Rename the heading Our History. And since it's the history we're talking about, we don't need any subheading here. So let's select the text and change it to body text. And then left align the text and do a little bit of paragraphing here as well. Now copy this text box to the right panel. Change the heading to Our Speciality. And I think we can let the body text remain as it is. Hit W to check the preview of the inside panel. And I think it's looking pretty decent. Let's head to the outside panel now. Pick the rectangle frame tool and create a rectangle covering the entire page on the right. Now go to File and then Place and locate the image on the computer and hit Open. Now select one of the yellow panels we created on the inside panel and copy it and then paste it here. Let's resize it and place it on the top as illustrated. And before we do anything with it, let's first establish the center of this page as well. So let's grab the rectangle tool and create a rectangle from the left margin till the margin on the right. Drag a guide from the ruler on the left and drop it at the center of this rectangle. Now delete the rectangle. With the help of this guide, let's center align the yellow rectangle and let's resize it to make it more a horizontal rectangle than a vertical one. Now grab the type tool and create a text box on top of this rectangle and let's type in Enigma Pizza. Let's center align it and change the font to Asylum. Now bring it to the center and update the font size to 18 points. Let's make another rectangle from the margin on top, excluding the bleed, till the bottom of the yellow rectangle. And then place another guide at the center of this rectangle. Now delete the rectangle. Align the text to the guide we've just created. Let's copy the yellow rectangle and place it at the bottom as illustrated. Make a text box on top of this rectangle and type in handcrafted goodness. Let's change the font to Typo Upright. Also, increase the font size to 30 points. Let's shorten the height of the rectangle and lower the opacity to about 78%. And also center align the text box. Let's make another copy of the yellow rectangle and place it at the bottom of the page on the right. Center align it with the help of the guide and then shorten it as we won't need such a big rectangle. Now grab the type tool and make a text box and type in a phone number. Let's center align it and change the font to Asylum. I think we need to shorten the height further, so let's just do that. And using a rectangle, establish the vertical center of the yellow rectangle, excluding the bleed. And then place a guide at the center of the rectangle. And then delete the rectangle. Now center align the text. Let's hit W to check the preview. I think we need to shorten the width of the rectangle, so let's do that. And then align the rectangle to the guide at the center. And then align the text to the yellow rectangle. Let's check the preview. I think we're done with this page, so let's move on to the page on the left. Let's make another copy of the yellow rectangle and extend it to the entire page in the center. Now grab the rectangle frame tool and make a rectangle from margin to margin as illustrated. Now let's go to File and then Place and locate the image on the computer and hit Open. Let's copy the text box from the inside page and paste it here. Let's change the heading to For Catering Service and then add the contact details. Also add other details like email address, website address, and social media details, and then center align the text box to this page. You are at liberty to add further details to this page as we have a lot of vacant space. Let's select the text and change the font to Roboto Light. Let's also select the heading and change the font style to medium. Actually, the body text has become way too light, so let's select it and change it to regular. Let's check the preview. I think it looks decent enough so far. Let's select the yellow block in the center page and holding Shift and Option on a Mac or Shift and Alt on a PC, click and drag to the left to make a copy. Now, shorten the rectangle to cover just half of the page. Pick the rectangle frame tool and make a rectangle from margin to margin as illustrated. Now let's go to File and then Place and locate the image on the computer and hit Open. Lastly, copy the text box from the inside page and paste it here. Change the heading to Our Bread. Make a subheading and type in anything that fits there. Now convert the rest of the text styling to body text and then left align it. Actually, let's increase the font size of the subheading to 18 points. Let's check the preview of the outside panel now. I think we need to do a little bit of alignment to the image on the left as the yellow panel behind the image is not aligned well. Let's grab the rectangle tool and make a rectangle from the margin on top till the beginning of the image. Let's fill it with black. Now place this rectangle at the bottom edge of the image and then shorten the yellow rectangle to the point of the black rectangle. Now delete the black rectangle. And there you go, guys. The Trifold brochure is ready. Alright, guys, that brings us to the close of the session and it's time for a short break. So I'll see you in just a bit. Goodbye.